uyaphila kimi.
Troubled on every side, yet not distressed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Cast down, but not destroyed. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus.
Jesus, Jesus. Otumo ngwele kuseni. I am the evidence of the cross. I am the evidence of the cross. I am the evidence of his wounds. I am the evidence of his wounds. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. I'm here today to say, devil, you are very late. I am the evidence of the finished work of Calvary. I am the evidence of his pierced side. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. I gave him my old tattered garment. He gave me a robe of pure white. And that's the reason I'm here this morning, to exalt him higher above all other gods. Glory to Jesus. Let me take this opportunity, beloved, and greet you all in the most gracious name, the name above all names, the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. As I warmly welcome you back to Beulah Land, if you are returning, thank you so much for the love and support and the loyalty. And if you are new here, my name is Beulah. I'm a daughter of Zion, a joint heir with the Son. One day when I was lost and undone, Jesus forged a relationship with me. And I'm here to decree and declare that my life will never be the same again. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. You know, when the Lord found me, I was sinking deep in sin, so overwhelmed by my own efforts, so full of self-righteousness. And he said to me, don't look at your clothes. I don't look at your clothes. I don't look at what you are. I look at who you are. Because who you are is who I am. Will you marry me? Hallelujah. It was love so undeserving. And he promised me a home in heaven. Glory to Jesus. He promised me peace that surpasses understanding. He promised me peace in the midst of the storm. Hallelujah. And that's the reason I'm here, beloveds, this morning to say, victory belongs to Jesus. I have come to a point where I realized it's not by might nor by power. It's not my own efforts. This is a message of thanksgiving to the Lord. This is me exalting Him higher above all other gods. I'm here to share the word of God. I'm here to say victory belongs to Jesus. Hallelujah. If you can remember clearly, sometime last year I said to you, there's a message that I want to share. But it looks like every time I want to share the message, that specific message, the Holy Spirit is saying it's not yet time. And I even made mention of the fact that when the time is right for me to share that message, I will let you know that this is the message that the Holy Spirit has been stopping me. Glory to Jesus. Sometime during the week, when I was standing before the mirror, making ready to leave, the Holy Spirit came back with this message that I'm here to share. I've never been this happy. Countless times, I've been tempted to share this message. I remember on the 31st of July, 2022, that is last year, I was invited to come share the word on the radio. And so it was actually my first time to go to the radio station. And then I said, good shot, I'm going to share this message. But the Holy Spirit still stopped me. You know, uyalalelwa umoya. I did not know the reason why I'm stopped. But I thank God, because I would have shared this message prematurely. I would have fed you a half-cooked meal. Basuto by bitsahlama. When you feed people something that is not well done, they call it hlama. And you know how the Holy Spirit appeared to me this week? I was so humbled. Every time when the Holy Spirit addresses me, I've realized I'll be standing before my mirror. I don't know if there's a spiritual application to that, but mostly when He reveals something to me, I'll be standing before the mirror. One day I'll come back with testimonies about my encounter with the Holy Spirit. For now, let us quickly turn together to Psalm 124. We read from verse 1 to the end. On my King James Version, it reads as follows. I'm rushing, beloved. This is a very short message that I'm going to be sharing with you. Hallelujah. It says, if it had not been the Lord who was on our side, now may Israel say, if it had not been the Lord who was on our side when men rose up against us, then they'd swallowed us up quick when their wrath was kindled against us. Then the waters had overwhelmed us, the stream had gone over our soul. Then the proud waters had gone over our soul. Blessed be the Lord who hath not given us as a prey to their teeth. Our soul is escaped as a bird out of the snare of the fowlers. The snare is broken and we are escaped. Our help is in the name of the Lord who made heavens and earth. Glory to Jesus. When an enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord raises a standard against him. Dearest Heavenly Father, the great I am, the author and the finisher of our faith, the lion of the tribe of Judah, the lily of the valley, the rose of Sharon, the high priest after the order of Melchizedek. We are come before your throne of grace once again, not by the works that we have done, but by your grace and your grace alone. I have just read your way to your children. Be the mouthpiece once again, Lord, as I decree, so you may increase. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.
When an enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord raises a standard against him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. Beloveds, I want us to once again read the psalm, but this time around, we're going to read it in a more personalized way. Where it's Israel, you're going to have to apply your name as I apply mine. If it had not been the Lord who was on our side, now may Beulah say. If it had not been the Lord who was on our side when men rose up against us, then they'd swallowed us up quick when their wrath was kindled against us. Then the waters had overwhelmed us, the stream had gone over our soul. Blessed be the Lord who hath not given us as a prey to their teeth. Our soul is escaped as a bird out of the snare of the fowlers. The snare is broken and we are escaped. Oh Jesus, our help is in the name of the Lord who made heaven and earth. My help is in the name of the Lord who made heaven and earth. Hallelujah. If it had not been the Lord who was on my side, the story would be different. If it had not been the Lord who was on my side, I wouldn't be where I am today. I wouldn't be this beautiful. I wouldn't be this vibrant. Hallelujah. And that's the reason I've titled my message, Victory Belongs to Jesus. Hallelujah. Athumhlabeleli izimo esindlula kuzo. Azisisi ekufeni. The challenges, the situations we encounter are not leading unto death. Uthi uNkulunkulu ubonisa uzuko lwakhe. He is demonstrating his glory. He is demonstrating his power. Hallelujah, beloved. You know, when this year started, when 2023 started, from the 6th of February, to be precise, when I lost the love of my life, I never thought I'd make it this far. The year is almost coming to an end. Yet I am still sane, beautiful, and vibrant. Allow me, beloveds, to say if it had not been the Lord who was on my side, the enemy would have swallowed me up. Ngizothi mina ekuseni nanoma niyangibona umusa wakhe nama ngazi ngiphunyuke kanjani ngifikelwa izinyembezi. I don't know how I escaped. Uma ngibuka intaba namahlathi endlule kuwo nasimakade angazi ngindlule kanjani. You know, to witness somebody you love deteriorating, without any help of some sort, it's another form of pain I can't dare explain.
I stood there as his coffin was descending 6 feet under. As if that was not enough, I heard people celebrating my tears. As if that was not enough, I heard people making promises they can't keep. Going to church became a thorn of some sort. I was judged to the uttermost. I never thought I could rise. I wanted to swap churches. I received some good and bad advices. Some persuaded me to leave the church. Some tried to show me how unfairly I was treated. And you know, against all odds, God raised a standard. He opened my eyes and I saw even those who were trying to get rid of me, those who posed like my supporters. Meanwhile, they wanted to see me gone. But he raised a standard. He made me wise like a serpent and harmless like a dove. If it had not been the Lord who was on my side, the enemy would have swallowed me. You know, I don't know how I made it this far. I don't even remember bathing and dressing up to church in the midst of grief. Surely there's somebody who carried me to and fro every Sunday. I couldn't even pray. I was too angry to pray. I was very angry at God. I was fuming. And I told myself, you know what? I'm done with God. I'm done with the Bible. I'm done with preaching. I'm done with this Christian life. And the devil came to sit right next to me. He pushed my angel aside and he embraced me. And he said, you remember when you were homeless for 8 years? You remember what they did to you at your previous church? You remember what happened? What so and so did? Oh, Beulah, my dear, Christianity is a shame. Just denounce it and pursue your career in modeling. Namangazi, ngiphunyuke kanjani, namanje ngisamangele. Namangazi, angazi ngiphunyuke kanjani, namanje ngisamangele. You know, I read a story, I read a poem entitled Footprints on the Sand of Time. It says there was a young girl who, along her journey of life, always noticed two sets of footprints on the sand. But it says, during the most difficult moments of her life, she'd notice only one set of footprints. And then she went to God and said, Father God, I've noticed that every time I'm in trouble, every time I'm grieving, every time, you know, something is happening, I notice only one set of footprints. Why do you always leave me when I need you the most? And then God said, my precious, precious child, I will never leave you nor forsake you. When you saw only one set of footprints, it was then that I carried you. Glory to Jesus. Whew, mighty God.
Namangazi, ngiphunyuke kanjani, namanje ngisamangele. I don't know, Lord. I don't know, Lord. But I'm here to say, victory belongs to Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus.
In the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 13, let us read it, beloveds. The Apostle Paul says, he says, there has no temptation taken you, but such as is common to men. But God is faithful, who will not suffer you to be tempted above that which ye are able, but will with the temptation also make a way to escape, that ye may be able to bear it. Hallelujah. God will not suffer you to be tempted above what you can bear. But also, when you are tempted, he's gonna make a way of escape. We serve such a merciful God. I said the other day, he is not only mighty, but he's also merciful. If he was mighty, we were gonna salute him. But since he's also merciful, we salute him as we approach him. In closing, I just wanna say, beloved, greater is he in you than the one in the world. You know, in the spiritual realm, a disadvantage is only a disadvantage if you don't know the kind of support or backup you have. No matter what kind of challenges you face, those challenges will never outnumber the kind of a support you have. Hallelujah. When you read in the book of 1 Kings chapter 6, verse 16 to 20, rather it's 2 Kings chapter 6, verse 16 to 20, the Bible says one morning when Elisha woke up in Dothan, he realized that the city was compassed about with soldiers, horses, and chariots. And so the young man who was with Elisha said, Master, what are we going to do? Hallelujah. And so Elisha said to the young man, Gehazi, fear not. The one who is with us is greater than the one who is with them. And he prayed, Lord, please open the eyes of this young man. And the Lord indeed opened his eyes, and he saw a mountain full of horses, chariots of fire round about Elisha. Hallelujah. Your situation is not above God. Or rather, let me bring it to your doorsteps. Your situation as a joint heir with the Son, as a gene from God, is not above you. May God, excuse me. May God open your eyes so that you can see that the one who is in you is greater than the one in your situation, is greater than the critics, is greater than the mockers, is greater than the scoffers, is greater than the witches. Hallelujah. You remember the three Hebrew boys? The Bible says they purposed in their hearts that under no circumstance will we ever bow to a strange God. And Nebuchadnezzar threw them into a fiery furnace. The Bible says, instead he saw a fourth man walking in the fire with them. And he said, the fourth one is like unto the Son of God. UNebuchadnezzar wamazi engakazalwa. He saw the Ancient of Days and he recognized him as the Son of God. He got to know the Son of God because of the faith of the three Hebrew boys, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Oh, Jesus! Do you know, beloved, you can never and will never preach a better sermon to the witches. Well, allow me to say this in Zulu. Whoever doesn't understand Zulu, we're going to talk it over in Beulah land. Ngizoyichaza eZulwini. Bayoshunyayezwa yilwane zabo, nemikhovu yabo, nenyoka zabo, abazithumele ebusuku kuwe. Those snakes will go back to them and say, no. We can't. Lo muntu simfice eno Jehova. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. Victory belongs to Jesus. It is not by might nor by power, but it is by grace and grace alone. Hallelujah. You are not a Christian by your own desire. You are a Christian by God's desire. Christianity is living a life that is not yours. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. May all glory and honor be unto him and him alone. Victory belongs to Jesus. It's not because we are learned. It's not because we are eloquent. It's not because we know the Bible. It is grace and grace alone. Hallelujah. May God bless you, beloveds. Ake sithi lilungile ijokwe lakho awuhluphu umthwalo wami ngiyabonga ngisahamba kanye nawe Nkosi yami. Lilungile ijokwe lakho awuhluphu umthwalo wami kodwa ngiyabonga ngisahamba. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, mighty God. Thank you, Jehovah Rapha, the Lord our healer. Thank you, Jehovah Shalom, the Lord our peace. Thank you, Jehovah Jireh, the Lord our provider. Oh, mighty God, we are the same yesterday, today, and forever. We are here, Lord Heavenly Father, to acknowledge your presence in our lives. We are here saying, Ebenezer, usiholile. Oh, mighty God, thus far, you have kept us. It was your grace and your grace alone that brought us safe thus far. We thank you, Lord Heavenly Father. Sithamba nathi indlela yonke ungasishisi sodwa. We thank you, Heavenly Father. We thank you, mighty God. Be lifted up above all other gods. We thank you that we are assured of victory for as long as we abide in you and you abide in us. Thank you, Lord, for the privilege of being called your children. Almighty God, thank you. Thank you for such a wonderful message that came to remind us that we are not alone. Heavenly Father, you have favored us this much to not let us walk on our own. The enemy is defeated. Thank you, mighty God. Hallelujah. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit abide in you until the Lord's return. God bless you.